I'll be speaking about Phaco emulsification in high myopia. What are the intraoperative tricks that we can use to tackle these cases? High myopia is associated with early cataract, higher intraoperative and postoperative complications. So intraoperative planning is also equally important. There are some factors like low scleral rigidity, deep anterior chamber, weak zonules, AC fluctuations, reverse pupillary block, and fluid deviation syndrome, which are peculiar with these high myopia cases. I usually prefer topical anesthesia, but subconjunctal and subtenon anesthesia are also good options. Peribulbar is preferable to avoid, because in some cases posterior scleroderma can cause perforation. While making incision, my preferred incision is limbal or corneal, 2.2 to 2.8 mm width with 1.5 mm length. Side incisions should be small and it should be clear corneal. It is better to avoid too long and too posterior incision because it makes the maneuvers difficult in a deep anterior chamber. Now, lens iris diaphragm retropropulsion syndrome, which leads to deep anterior chamber and discomfort to the patient because of reverse pupillary block. To remove this block, it is important to lift the iris so the block is reversed and the anterior chamber becomes normal. In slow motion, you can see here, because of irrigation, there is sudden deepening of anterior chamber and this leads to discomfort of the patient. To reduce this, lower the bottle height before you enter the anterior chamber, lift the iris up and then slowly enter with the low intraocular pressure. In case of cataract surgery with high myopia and the cataract is very soft, I generally use the technique of prolapsing the nucleus out of the bag after doing a good size CCC. And then Phaco aspiration of this prolapsed nucleus without using much of Phaco energy. Because we are not using much of Phaco energy here, the endothelium will not be damaged, and also doing all the maneuvers quite anterior avoids any posterior capsular problems. It is important to only use the aspiration and not use the Phaco. In case of high myopia with hard cataract, the most important thing is to do all the maneuvers where you are doing the splitting sideways. Avoid pushing the nucleus down, because in such cases, because of low scleral rigidity, there is a tendency of pushing the nucleus down, and this leads to zonular dehiscence as well as rent. I usually prefer to use CTR for larger eyes and with deeper anterior chambers, because the CTR helps in centration of the IOL and also prevents capsular phimosis. It is important to have a good size CCC in high myopia cases to prevent anterior capsular phimosis. Wound closure. In case of wound closure, because of low scleral rigidity, what happens is that as you hydrate the wound, the AC deepens and the lens iris diaphragm is pushed backwards. This may lead to discomfort as well as decentration and zonular stretching. To avoid that, I sometimes use this sandwich technique where I make a lamellar incision over the main incision and then I hydrate the lamellar incision. In this way, the wound is sealed without increasing IOP and deepening the anterior chamber. This avoids decentration of the IOL as well. Fluid deviation syndrome is also seen quite often with high myopia. It is important to avoid high IOP for prolonged period during Phaco. Use mechanized pole, and in case of fluid deviation develops causing shallow anterior chamber and positive vitreous pressure, you can just close the case and operate next day after controlling IOP. Other option is doing pars plana limited vitrectomy to reduce the vitreous pressure and complete the case.